What's good YouTube? Welcome to my tutorial for Easy's Ship Refueler script, previously known as Easy's Battery Recharge Helper. This video comes as a special request from the mod author, Dare Easy, after he saw my tutorial for Easy's Inventory Manager and made it the official video on the Steam page for that. Thank you for that, I do appreciate it. The main purpose of this script is to refuel your ships with whatever fuel that they're using while they are docked. That way you always have a completely recharged ship whenever you leave your docking bay. In order to use this script on your ship, all you need to do is add a programming block and then import Easy's Ship Refueler script from the workshop. I'm going to assume that you already know how to do this. If not, there are plenty of videos that will help you with scripts. I've even covered this in previous videos such as Easy's Inventory Manager tutorial, which if you want to see that, you can click the annotation in the upper right hand corner of your screen now. So the main features of this are automatically setting batteries to recharge. That's the main feature of the entire script if you ask me. You can also black and white list specific connectors, as well as trigger timers at specific events like battery level or docking time. Another very useful feature of this script is being able to automatically control your lights based on the current light level if you have a solar panel installed, as well as an emergency backup reactor and hydrogen engine support. This script also allows you to use LCDs to give you a status report on everything, as well as statistics in the block's names, just like Easy's Inventory Manager. In this video, I will be covering each one of these options. As always, when importing a script into your game, make sure you check code immediately to make sure everything is running fine with the script and there's no errors. You can then choose OK and load the script into your programmable block. This is all you really need to do if you don't want to use any of the extra features that comes along with it. This will recharge your batteries when docked. And you can see that it's working by looking on the lower right hand corner of your programmable block where it says Easy's Ship Refueler. If there's anything wrong with the way that the script is running, there will be an error code thrown here. At the bottom of this output is a hint to build an LCD and add the main LCD keyword !ISR-main to its name. We're going to go ahead and do that so we can get an output that we can see from outside of the programmable block. Anytime that I need to rename a block for a script, I like to go back into the script itself, into the code editor, because they will generally have a copy-pastable string that you can use. That way you are absolutely certain that you do not type the wrong thing. So what we're going to do here is we're going to go ahead and find the string main LCD keyword and copy this keyword into the LCD name. Once you've done this, you'll know it updated correctly if you see Easy LCD show up in the LCD panel. Now moving out to the LCD panel that we just named, you can see that it has input, output, charge and other things as well, which can be edited in the custom data here. So if you want to change anything that's shown, all you have to do is go into the custom data and edit this accordingly. The defaults here are headings, warnings, connection status, power time, emergency power, battery status, tank status, light status, and whether or not you want to scroll. On to the main configuration for the script. Here is where Easy's scripts really shine, in my opinion. Even though he originally makes the scripts for one single purpose, he also updates the scripts and allows you to do so many different things, and you can pretty much cover everything that you want to do with his scripts. So the first option under configuration in the script is whether or not you want a specific group of batteries to be covered. With the script, you can choose here if you want to leave specific batteries uncovered by the script. I don't really see the purpose of this, but if you can think of one, let me know down in the comments below. Maybe that's a question for Dare Easy, if he has any personal ideas for that one. The next option that you have is whether or not to set batteries to discharge when not docked. If that is set to false, then it will basically just set it to auto, which allows it to charge and discharge, whether or not it's using the energy. You could set that if you wanted to drain the batteries for whatever reason and not recharge them using the onboard stuff. You can also decide to keep one backup battery or not. I'd recommend using this and setting it to true at all times. That way you've always got one battery that is turned on in case something happens, and it will keep your ship from just falling from your docking port. This will cover things like power outages or players hitting P and accidentally undocking all the ships connected to the base at once. There's also an option whether or not to fill the tanks, and you can also set groups for the tanks here. So if you wanted to carry hydrogen from one place to the other and not use it for recharging the battery at all and just have specific backup tanks for recharging the battery, this is where you set it. If you want to create connectors that do not actually trigger this script, this can be useful if you have, say, a transport ship that transports automatically from one base to another. You can set it up to where when it was picking up, it won't recharge, but when it is at the main base, it will recharge. You would just take the connector that you connect to the secondary base and put that in the group that you put into the connector group name here. There's also an option here called no refuel that will allow you to not refuel or charge the batteries from the connector. That could be useful under the same situation if you did not want to use the hydrogen from one base to go into the ship that you have running back and forth. And the ignore keyword will allow you to ignore an entire connector and just not run the script at all off of that connector. You can also choose no recharge and discharge at connector as well. Discharge at connector could be useful if you wanted to fill up the batteries of a base using the ship's battery stores. Following the logic from before, you can also choose no O2 filling and no H2 filling as well. Basically, you can choose exactly what each connector will do. And next, we have the options for what could quite possibly be the most useful thing in this script, which is the emergency power generation. If you have a nuclear reactor and or hydrogen engines on your ship, you can set them up to automatically turn on and off based off of the power levels of your batteries. That will keep you from running out of power, basically emergency backup generator system. You can choose the order in which they activate. You can also choose the activation scenarios such as low battery power, overload, very useful, damaged batteries, and no batteries. This will allow you to get that extra boost of power generation due to a failure. Under thresholds, you can also choose what threshold percentage that you want them to activate. The defaults are 10% for low charge for on, and then kick back off at 15%. The next option is light control. This actually brings up a good point. This is why you want to check code. Here I typed the word incorrectly, T-R-U-E-E, and it actually caused a problem with check code, which in turn prevented the script from running. Another thing of note is that the double strings here, like light level here, they're actually twice what the value you want. So if you want, say, 25% for the light level, that is 50. If you wanted 10%, you would have to put 20. The next option is to allow you to choose which solar panels that you want to use. So you can choose a solar panel group if you want to for that. And you can also choose specific lights such as interior lights, spotlights, and position lights as well for the automatic light control. You can also choose to change the names of the LCDs if you want to. This could help if you wanted to keep a specific naming convention on your ship. You can also choose the warnings and performance LCD panels if you want to. as well as the default font, which is debug or monospace if you wish, and the default font size as well. Under terminal statistics, you can also choose to show the battery stats, tank stats, power device stats, or the solar stats in the name of the block. It will actually update the name based off of the percentage that it is sitting at. The default option for this is true. You can also use timer blocks to trigger on specific events such as docking, undocking, and battery percentages. I actually use this to set up a color scheme for lights based on the battery percentages. One important thing about this is that the syntax very much matters, so make sure you get the space in between the comma and the parentheses as well. In order to do this, I followed the convention that Easy set up under his example. I then made a couple timer blocks and then named them according to what they were in the script, at which point I placed 4 spinning lights, which I then colored red, green, and 2 different shades of yellow. At that point, I named them according to what percentage I wanted them to activate, grouped them all together, and set my timer blocks with a delay of 1 for instant activation to cut off all of the other lights and cut on the correct light accordingly. And finally, I needed to group together all of the interior lights that I was not using for the system and add the group name to the configuration of the script. With this script, I was able to quickly create a small ship with automatic battery recharge and emergency power generation, with battery charge indication, and automatic lighting control. Thank you for watching the video all the way through. Please drop a like to let me know that you did. If you have an idea for another mod or script that you'd like to see covered, drop it in the comments below. Also, please help us reach our goal of 1,000 subscribers. If you like what you saw and you'd want to see more, click one of the 2 videos on your screen now. Thank you. Have a nice day.